Always make sure you are downloading the correct wallet. There are a bunch of fake applications out there that will steal your funds. To be sure, get the download link directly from the source. That means you should go to trustwallet.com and download the app from this website. This is the only source you can trust. In the next few minutes, I'm going to show you all you need to get started with Trust Wallet, so keep watching until the end if you care about the safety of your cryptocurrencies. Let's continue by clicking the appropriate download link for your mobile device. Since I'm on Android, I'll select Google Play. Trust Wallet is the Binance official crypto wallet, and its main purpose is to store Bitcoin, Ethereum and Ethereum-based tokens, XRP, Litecoin, BNB and many more other coins. Binance is the biggest and most popular cryptocurrency exchange, and since Trust Wallet is their official wallet, you'll find some Binance functionality in this app. So make sure you are downloading and installing the correct application and we can get started. I don't recommend using Trust Wallet or any other mobile wallet to store more cryptocurrency than you would keep in your pocket. If you don't go around with $1,000 in your pocket, then don't hold $1,000 worth of crypto in the mobile wallet. Unless you are trading these cryptocurrencies or sending and spending crypto frequently, you don't have to keep them in the mobile wallet. It's always safer to use a hardware wallet. Mobile wallets are convenient and should be used for their convenience, but take cryptocurrency safety seriously and store them accordingly. That being said, Trust Wallet is a private and secure wallet. You are the owner of the cryptocurrency and their safety is your responsibility now. You can store multiple cryptocurrencies with only this one app. You can even trade your cryptocurrency with this app, but that's an added feature, not its main purpose. The main purpose of the app is to store your crypto safely and be the best at that. Anything else, it's a bonus. In the Android-only version of the app, you can connect to your wallet directly to decentralized apps straight from this wallet application. If you use another wallet right now and you want to switch to Trust Wallet, all you have to do is to click on the I already have a wallet option. Of course, you should understand and accept the terms of service and privacy policy, and finally enter your seed phrase here. If you don't have a compatible seed phrase, you can't restore your wallet and you'll have to create a new one. I'll explain more about the seed phrase by creating a new wallet. So if you are new and just want to create a wallet, choose this option from the start screen. This step is crucial for the safety of your cryptocurrency. You are about to see the recovery seed phrase that will allow you to restore your wallet in case something happens to your device. You can say it's the master password to your cryptocurrency. If you have this, you can restore your crypto anywhere on any device. If you don't have it, your cryptocurrencies are lost forever. If you share this seed phrase with anyone, they get full access to your coins and they can just spend them in your behalf. So never share your seed phrase with anyone. Just like you don't share your card PIN number with anyone, no one else needs to know this seed phrase. So understand that if you lose the recovery words, you will not be able to access the wallet anymore. I'm sharing this seed phrase with you for educational purposes only. See the copy and show QR code? Don't use them. Don't store this recovery seed phrase digitally, on your phone or on your computer. Don't take a screenshot, don't take a photo. Take a pen and paper and write these words down. Then store this piece of paper safely, as your wealth depends on it. The order of the words is crucial, so write them in the correct order. It also says in the app, never share the recovery phrase with anyone. Store it securely. If anyone, no matter who he or she is, asks for this seed phrase, they want to steal your crypto. You have been warned. Are you following my advice? Let me know in the comments below just by writing I do. When you're ready, click on continue. Now tap the recovery phrase in the correct order to confirm it. When ready, click on done. Congratulations, now you have a new wallet for your crypto. I can now continue with less dramatic instructions. From this home screen, you can see the wallet balance, which is of course zero. There are send, receive and buy buttons. I'm going to show you how to send and receive crypto in just a couple of minutes. You can also see the balance for each individual coin in your wallet. You can have as many coins as you like and you can choose which ones are displayed and which ones are hidden. Click on the button on the top right corner of the screen and turn on and off any coin you want to be displayed or not. If you can't find your desired token, you might be able to add it as a custom token. Find your token on coingecko.com, copy the contract address and paste it in the Trust Wallet app. The other fields will auto-complete and you'll be able to track your desired token in the app. If you click any asset in your wallet, you will see your balance, history of transactions, as well as send and receive buttons. You can also see a price chart and more information about the specific coin you are browsing by clicking on the chart icon in the top right corner of the screen. The main purpose of a crypto wallet is to send, receive and safely store your cryptocurrency. Any other feature is a bonus. In this video, I'm going to cover sending and receiving Bitcoin, then I'll go over the rest of the bonus functionalities in my next video. You can withdraw your funds from any existing cryptocurrency exchange to your Trust Wallet. The value of your funds will go up and down as usual, just like they would on the exchange. If you ever want to sell, you'll send your funds from the wallet to the exchange and continue selling there. So let's send some Bitcoin from my Coinbase account to my Trust Wallet. You can copy your Bitcoin address directly by clicking on the copy button. You can also click on the receive button, where you can see the QR code that some applications applications might let you scan it to share your address. If you need to copy this address to your computer, you can click on the share button and either send an email to yourself with the address, or if you use Telegram on both your mobile device and computer, just forward the message to your personal saved messages page. For now, I'll just copy the address by clicking the copy button and hop on the Coinbase app. From the Coinbase app, click the middle button at the bottom of your screen. Select send and type in the amount you want to send. When you are done, click on continue. Paste in the address you just copied, but always make sure you pasted the correct address. Don't just assume it's correct, always double and triple check. The address is correct, so I can continue with the withdrawal on the Coinbase app by clicking on preview send. On Coinbase, you'll find the smallest withdrawal fee for any crypto exchange. The network fee is fixed. It doesn't matter if you withdraw $1 or $10,000 worth of Bitcoin, the fee will be the same. I'll tap send now to finish sending the funds. The transaction needs to go through the Bitcoin network, so I'll have to wait a few minutes until that's done. Trust Wallet can see an incoming transfer, so it will appear here. The transfer is not yet confirmed, so I cannot spend my funds yet. Only when the transaction is complete, I'll be able to do whatever I want to do with my coins that are in my Trust Wallet. You cannot directly exchange crypto from the Trust Wallet to your bank account. What you have to do is to first withdraw to a cryptocurrency exchange that supports bank transfers, anything between Coinbase, Kraken, or crypto.com, sell your crypto for money there, and finally withdraw to your bank. I have a specific video about that, so check the link in the top right corner of the video or in the description below. See the network fee that's over $62? You don't have to worry about that. Coinbase paid for it, not you. All crypto exchanges do withdrawals in batches and they will pay a higher fee, but they will only charge you what you agreed on at the time of your withdrawal. Now that the transaction is complete and the funds are in my wallet, I can send them wherever I want. All I need is the destination address. If I want to sell my crypto on an exchange, I'll use my exchange wallet address. If I want to withdraw to my hardware wallet, I'll take my address from there. So I'll click on the send button, paste in the address that I want to withdraw to, and the amount I wish to send. Unlike withdrawing from a crypto exchange, in Trust Wallet I can adjust how much I want to pay for the network fee. But pay attention, the lower I'm willing to pay for the network fee, the longer I have to wait for the transaction to be complete. The faster I want my transaction to be confirmed, the more I will have to pay for the network fee. If you don't care about the network fee, just continue by tapping send. Otherwise, on mempool.space, you can see the current network fees paid by the network. If you want high priority, anything above 96 sats per virtual byte should confirm your transaction in the next 10 minutes. A medium priority fee should be confirmed within 20 minutes. But if you don't care if your transaction gets confirmed in the next hours or days, anything between 2 and 20 sats per virtual byte will do. You can change the network fee by clicking on the cogwheel icon at the top of your Trust Wallet screen. Change to your desired value and tap on save. Now you will see your updated network fee. But remember, the lower the fee, the longer it will take for the transaction to be confirmed. If you want to learn about the bonus functionalities of the Trust Wallet, click the subscribe button to be notified when I'm posting my next video. I'll also add the link to the video on the screen right now. But until that video is out, you can watch this one, which I'm sure will interest you as well. I'll see you there.